carried out the calculation of heat capacity. Calculation of heat capacity. Write down. It is the heat required, heat capacity definition. It is the heat required to change the temperature by heat capacity. Write down. It is the heat required to change the temperature by. Temperature by 1 degree Celsius. Okay, so total heat capacity is C. The unit of C is heat capacity. Unit is, we represent this by C, and unit of this is joule per Kelvin degree Celsius. That also you can do, because change in temperature we have, whether it
right. So this is specific, right?
This is total heat capacity.
Specific.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah.
Right. So this is actually total heat capacity. C. Now this total heat capacity we have two types. One is molar. Another one is specific heat capacity. What is molar heat capacity? It is a heat capacity per unit mole, for one mole. Write down, it is the molar heat capacity is it again two types here, Cp and Cv, at constant pressure and constant volume. Specific heat capacity is represented by S. MS delta T per hour, physics.
Last year we learned
MC delta T. MC delta T also you write. Specific heat capacity also write it. Because we are using this for C, so here we are writing it as MS delta T. Point is, unit you must take care of. If per gram, if it is there, then specific. Per mole, then it is. Write on molar heat capacity. It is the amount of heat required. Yeah, it is the amount of heat required to change the temperature by 1 degree Celsius for 1 mole of a system. Right, so molar heat capacity, we can write this as Cm. Specific heat capacity is S. So molar heat capacity, the unit of this is joule per mole Kelvin. For 1 mole it is. And this is for 1 gram. So joule per
kilogram per
Kelvin. Okay. A specific heat capacity is for 1 unit gram. 1 gram.
So that gram shouldn't be
kg. We define it as per gram. If you convert this into kg, then the value will only change.
Yeah, but then it should be SI.
Actually, we defined as per unit mass. Per unit mass. Gram cannot, won't be proper. Per unit mass is specific. Per unit mole is molar. That would be better. Okay, per unit mass. So, unit of mass, you can take anything, gram, kilogram, anything. Okay. Now, write down in isothermal process, first one write down in this only, isothermal process. What is isothermal process? Delta T will be 0, right? There's no change in temperature then. Then molar heat capacity will be what? Q is equals to, we can write C delta T by definition. What is C here? Total heat capacity. And this is given by Q delta T. Means Q is what? Q is the energy or heat required. Energy or heat. And this is change in temperature. So heat capacity is what? It is the heat required, energy required to change in temperature by 1 degree Celsius. So this is the formula of this. Q is equal to C delta T. Right? Where C is the total heat capacity. If it is molar heat capacity, we can write this as N Cm delta T. N number of moles. M S delta T. M is the mass. For molar heat capacity and specific heat capacity. S is the specific heat capacity, Cm is the molar heat capacity. So now when you have isothermal process, isothermal process, delta T is equals to 0. Okay? And when delta T is 0, C is what? Delta T is 0. So Q by 0 is
infinity.
So isothermal we have, see, first of all, we are taking this condition in isothermal process, what happens? You are providing heat, equal amount of work you do, temperature will be constant.
So no matter how much energy you use,
that's what it is. So how the temperature won't change? The energy that you are providing it, utna hi kaam kar diya hota. Theek hai, temperature constant ho gaya. So point is, this is the condition we are taking. Q kya ho raha hai, usse lena dena nahi hai. Delta T will be 0, C will be infinity. Right? In adiabatic process, what happens? Adiabatic?
Q is also 0.
Delta Q is 0. And when delta Q is 0, C is 0.
Okay.
So,
specific
heat capacity. Cm is molar heat capacity.
Okay. So, and M is mass.
M is this M. Oh, this is mass. This is mass. Because per unit mass we have this. S is per unit mass. Okay? Isocoring process, write down next. Isocoring process. Isocoring is volume. So in isocoring process, the heat capacity we write it as Cv. Right? So write down in isocoring process, the molar heat capacity is Cv. Now Cm becomes Cv. See, there are many terms into this. If you don't understand this properly, it will always haunt you in this chapter.
So what did you say?
What I said, Cm is the molar heat capacity. Now I am considering isochoric process. So in isochoric process, volume is constant. So molar heat capacity in isochoric process, we write it as Cv. Okay?
So we'll
see that. First of all, you write down. In isochoric process, the molar heat capacity is Cv. Write it down. Right? And by the basic definition of this, Cv, what we can write? dQ by dt, right? Lik sakta hoon main ye. Energy required to change the temperature by 1 degree, right? And this is at what? Since we have V here, so this is at constant volume. Theek hai? Now from first law of thermodynamics, when constant volume is there, then work done will be what? Zero. Work done will be zero, first law of thermodynamics. Work done will be zero, so dQ is equals to what we have? dU. Hoga? dQ is equals to, what we can write? dQ is equals to dU plus dW. Likh sakte hai ye. First law of thermodynamics. Abhi kiya just. Theek hai? So when volume is constant, this becomes 0. So dQ is equals to dU. So dU I can substitute here.
Sir, but isn't it delta U?
Then also it's fine. By the system, on the system. I agree, dQ is equals to dU. Theek hai? So dQ I can write here as dU. So Cv is equals to what we can write? dU by dt. Right? So this we can write it as what? dU is equals to Cv dt. This is for one mole. Correct? Because molar tha, yahan pe molar capacity tha. So for n number of moles, what we can write? dU is equals to n Cv dt.
Yeah.
Okay, and see, why are you here? Generally, if you see in the book, they are derived like this only. As I like that, DU is equal to strength sensitivity. Okay? But here, it is not very sure that it is applied for only ideal gas or with rigid boundary. Okay? So the previous expression that we did, there we have taken the condition of ideal gas and rigid boundary. Okay? So this is, like this also you can derive this particular thing.
So here, dW is 0 because dE volume.
Because volume is constant. And work done is what? P delta V.
Yes,
so volume is constant, so work done is zero. Okay? Now, right on next, the last one, we'll take a break after this. Isobaric process. Isobaric process is what? Constant pressure. So like we have constant volume, C becomes CM becomes CV. So your constant pressure, CM becomes CP. Okay? Yeah, what happened? Isobaric process, write down, the molar heat capacity is CP. And definition of enthalpy we haven't done, but we'll do it. So what we can write, Cp is equals to, again, the basic definition is what? dQ by dT at constant pressure. Right? What is the definition of enthalpy? It is a change in energy at constant pressure. Enthalpy of any system, it is a change in energy. dQ at constant pressure is nothing but dH. Enthalpy definition we'll see. Okay? See, all these things... you need to अभी हम लोग कुछ हम लोग बस समझ रहे हैं टॉपिक क्या है टर्म्स क्या है ठीक है सो इसको याद रखना है व्हाट इज एंथैल्पी इट इज अ चेंज इन एनर्जी एट कांस्टेंट प्रेशर दैट इज द डेफिनेशन मैथमेटिकल डेफिनेशन ऑफ dH इज व्हाट dH इज इक्वल्स टू dU प्लस p डेल्टा v ये है मैथमेटिकल डेफिनेशन ठीक है इस इक्वेशन से मैथमेटिकली वी डिफाइन लाइक दिस बट थ्योरेटिकली हम लोग क्या बोलते हैं इट इज द चेंज इन एनर्जी एट कांस्टेंट प्रेशर ठीक है So we'll see this enthalpy pe dekhenge but ek cheez yahan bas derive kar le then we'll move on okay so at constant pressure dq becomes what dh okay so cp is equals to dh by dt at constant pressure so dh is equals to what we can write cp dt okay for one mole so for n number of moles dh is equals to n cp We'll do enthalpy and then we'll see this expression.
It's like the same for all of them. Kind of like the same thing for all of them.
No, in this we'll see how this enthalpy is related with pressure and volume, temperature. We'll see that.
All of them are equal to like number of moles in terms of the heat capacity in terms of change.
Yeah, because we have only constant pressure, so we'll write Cp and not Cv. But the expression is correct.
So what is the equation you wrote connecting dH and dQ?
dH and dQ will do that, after this we'll do that, but if you want, you can write this as same, dQ is equal to dU plus dW, so constant pressure, we'll write this as same, just a second, float is what, dQ is equal to dU plus dW, constant pressure, liya. So dQ kya ho gaya? dH ho gaya, constant pressure, ठीक है? dU, dU रह गया, and dW क्या लिख सकते हैं, dP into V, work done to P into V. A pressure to constant M. So we can take this out. So dH is equal to dU plus P dV. ठीक है? Understood. dH is equal to dU plus P dV. But we'll do this. अभी करेंगे इसको. That is the definition of enthalpy. Enthalpy is the change in energy at constant pressure. Definition. So देखेंगे हम लोग enthalpy फिर से. ठीक है? So
But don't worry, I'll
write down the question. Find the work done. Find the work done when 18 ml. Write down the question. Find the work done when 18 ml of water is getting vaporized. 18 ml of water is getting vaporized at 373 Kelvin. 373 Kelvin in open vessel. In open vessel. Assume ideal gas in here.
Like if you're
volume is given, no. 18 ml. 18 ml it is given. Number of moles is not given, you can consider that as one mole.
So it's not given in STP. So this is 18 ml, so 18 grams, so it's 1 mole.
Because what you need to find out, work done, right?
Yes.
Work done is what? P delta V. Pressure is given. Open vessel. So pressure at atmosphere, pressure, that is constant. So just you need to find out final volume. 18 ml is given, find out V and then find out P delta V.
Oh, and we can find the final volume.
Yes, dV is equal to ml.
So what is R
value? R value is volume is liter, no pressure. 0.08. See, pressure is one atmospheric, volume is in liter. So R value should be 0.08.
Which is 1 by 12.
Yeah, exactly. You can assume that. So approximation you get.
30.1.
Yeah, it's almost correct. Approximately 30-31 you will get. So P delta V will be minus P into delta V is 30 minus 18, but 18 ml we have.
So this was 30 ml.
30 ml you get. A liter. It should be liter, I guess.
Yes,
30 liter. So 18 ml and 30 liter you have to subtract 18 ml from that. So just you neglect that. So probably 30 you are getting. What is the final volume you are getting?
Around 31.
Around 31, right? So work done is what? P delta V? Correct? So work done is equals to, see, first of all, we need to find out PV is equals to LRT will apply. Initial volume VI is given, which is 18 ml. Open vessel we have, so pressure is nothing but 1 atmospheric, equals to the atmospheric pressure. Right? So this number of moles is 1, R is 0.0821, temperature is 373 Kelvin, is equals to pressure into volume, or pressure is 1, so 1 into V. Atmospheric, you take liter, atm, you take. So what is final volume here? Approximately?
31.
31 you are getting, approximately.
31 minus
0.08. Right, so work done is equals to minus P delta V. Right, P is given, that is 1. Delta V is 31 minus 18 into 10 to the power minus 3.
Can you just say that that's...
Yeah, this you can neglect also, depending upon the option what is given. So approximately the answer will be? Yeah, the unit of this is what? ATM liter. This is ATM liter, right? So depending upon the option, you can change into joules also. So minus 31 into 101.3.